Hello guys, this is Chandra. Welcome to Learning Ladder of C Language. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about the break statement. This conditional statement is used for the abnormal jumping out of the conditional execution loop, like for loop, while loop, and do while. Here and given the syntax of this break statement, break followed by semicolon. Now let's see the functionality of this break statement in detail in a program. Now let's see the functionality of this break statement in C language. Here I am written a small program by using this break statement. First let's compile this program. Yeah, we are getting while only one time in the output side. Now let's see the internal flow of this program. While this while is printed only once. In the first step, I am initializing an integer variable with constant 10. In the next step, I am checking the by condition that I is less than 11 by using the while loop control structure. In the while loop control structure, in the first step, I am going to print a printf statement with while as a string. In the third, I use the break statement. So, what happened while C compiler encodes this break statement? In the sense, suppose the C compiler encodes a break statement, automatically it's not going to check any condition whether it is false or true or not. So it's going to terminate abnormally this conditional loop. So for this reason, we are getting while only once. And so in the next step, the C compiler encodes the break, so automatically not going to execute once again the while loop. It's going to terminate this loop abnormally. So C compiler come out this loop and we are not getting any while in the second time. Now let's see what happens if suppose I'm not using break statement over here. I'm getting infinity times the while. So this is the main advantage of this break statement. This break statement is utilized where we want to stop and loop of control structure with the particular condition. Now let's see an example how this break statement can be utilized in C program for conditional termination of this loop. Now let's see how this break statement can be utilized in C program. Here I am declaring while loop control structure with an condition that plus plus I and less than 110. So if suppose if we are not declaring any break statement in the sense, then this while loop should be executed for 100 times. So we have to get 100 times this while in the output statement. So I am not in the position to get 100 times this while in the output statement. So for this reason, I am declared that I equal to 15 as in the if loop. In the if loop, I am declared as a break statement. So while this program is executed, then we are going to get while 5 times only in the output screen. First, let's compile this program. Yeah, we are getting 5 times while in the output screen. So, like this break statement can be utilized for the conditional break of a control loop structure without and checking the condition in this control loop structure. By using this if condition statements or any other conditional statements like a ternary or greater conditional statement. I have written another example by using by break conditional statement to check whether the given number is a prime number or not. Now let's see an internal program coding. In this kind of statement, I am going to get the number that we have to check whether it's a prime number or not. Initially, the I variable is insulated with the two constant value. So here this while loop going to be executed until the I value is less than or equal to num minus 1. This will because we check the prime number, it should be not divisible with 2 and the n minus 1 values. So for this reason, I'm declaring the condition like this, and the first step I'm saying this value with the two constant, and next step I'm going to check that whether this num is modulated with I. So to check a prime number should not be divisible with any of the number between 2 and this n minus 1. So for this reason, if suppose any one number is exactly divisible by a minterm number, it's going to return a remainder as 0. So if computer, suppose the division value is 0, then the printf should be executed, not a prime number. So and we have to break this loop. So suppose a number I entered as 6, in the sense, then it's going to divisible with a 2. So in the first step itself, its remainder is 0. So it should print not a prime number, and then automatically we should break the loop. This is why, because if the number is divisible by 2, then it's obviously not going to be a prime number. So it is not necessary to check for the other numbers. So like this, we can use a break statement for the conditional termination of a loop based on our requirement. Here I entered 8 as an input, I'm getting a not a prime number. Now let's see what happened if suppose I'm using a break statement the inner while loop condition. In this example, I'm written in while loop, and inside this while loop, and I'm also declaring a second while loop. So this kind of program is known as the inner while loop conditions. So first, let me execute this program without a break statement. Yeah, we are getting 9 while 1 as a first printf statement. So it next we are going to get while 2 9 times, and then the while 1 once again 3 times. Now let's see what happened internally. The program is, first we are initializing I value and j value to 0. In the next step, I am going to increment this I value with 1, and I am checking that condition is I less than 5. So it is true. So going to printf statement. So for this reason, we are getting y 1 in the output statement. Next, it's going to check that j value is going to be incremented. Now it's 1. It's going to check whether it's less than 9. So it is true. So we are getting while 2 the second time. So this condition, this while loop is going to be executed 9 times. So for this reason, we are getting 9 times a while 2. After executing this inner while loop 9 times, we're going to check once again that I value is less than 5 by incrementing I value is 1. Now y value is 2. So I 2 is less than 5. It is 2. So we are getting while 1 in the output screen. So in next, it's going to check that the inner while loop condition that j is less than 9. In the previous execution, the j value is incremented by 9. So obviously, this condition is going to be failed while it's starting to execute the second time this inner while loop condition. So we are not getting any while 2 in the output screen. So once again, going to check the condition of outer while loop that I is less than 5. Now the I value is 3. So we are getting while 1 in the output screen. Like this, is while 1 is executed 5 times and while 2 is executed 9 times. Now let's see what happens if suppose I'm using a break statement in this program. Yeah, we are getting while 1 3 times, 4 times, and while 2 4 times. This is why, because this outer while loop is going to be executed 4 times. So we are declaring the while loop inner this outer while loop, so it should be executed 4 times by checking this condition. So once it is entered into this inner while loop, it's going to first step, it's going to print while 2 in the output screen. Next step, going to read the break. So automatically, while reading the break statement, it's automatically terminate this inner while loop condition. So this break statement never has any effect on this outer while loop condition. So for this reason, once again, this outer while loop is going to be executed. So after reading this inner while loop condition, it automatically starts executing this inner while loop condition freshly, and so we are getting printf statement in the output stream once again the while loop condition. Now let's see what happened. For our clear understanding purpose, I'm going to use this printf statement after the break. We are getting only while 1 in the output screen. This is because the break statement is written as a first statement in this inner while loop, so it's not going to be executed. Whenever it's the while loop, inner while loop is going to be executed, the first step is going to read the break statement. Automatically, it's going to terminate this while loop. Once again, it's going to check for outer while loop. So next, in the second step, the inner while loop is started executed. Then once again, the break statement is read, So we're not going to execute anything in this inner while loop. So once again, it's going to declare while loop only. So for this reason, we are getting only while one in the output script. We are not getting any while two in the output script. So by this, we can have a conclusion that the break statement will have an only effect on the inner while loop condition, not for the outer while loop conditions. That's all about this break statement, how it will work in C compiler, how we can utilize this break statement in the C program. So thank you, don't forget to subscribe to get alert for the next tutorial video.